Mike Nielsen from Cheap Trick, Sports Life Report. It's my favorite show. First of all, I want to welcome you back to Australia.
Glad to be here.
During these turbulent times, just wonder what fans can expect about the Under the Sunderstands tour with Bush and Sun Temple Pilots from you guys.
1 hour of good Cheap Trick rock and roll. It's going to be good.
How long are your sets going to be for?
I guess we only have 1 hour each.
What I love about this format is like you are changing the headliners every single time. So how did that come from? What's the promoter? You guys flip a coin? How do you guys work it out?
I think it's they pick. So I think we have four shows where headliners. I think we're all headliners. Some, you know. Well, are you the last band to be on? Is that what you're considered, the headliner?
You never know. You guys are rock and roll legends. You have been rocking from 73, and you're still going, and you have been creating a generation of rock fans around the world. What would you say is the Cheap Trick secret for the longevity?
The fact that we like to play. So it's like, if you hire us, we'll come. And that's what's happened. It's all good.
Many guitarists in the world aspire to be you.
No way.
A lot of them. And even as an anecdotic way, once back in the day I met Eddie Vedder from Pearl Jam, and I was wearing my Cheap Trick shirt, and he said, like, cool shirt, that's one of my favorite bands. So
Eddie said that?
Yeah. So how do you guys feel when that happened? Like, you are influenced for all the generations.
Well, it's pretty exciting when other musicians say that they like you. You know, like Bush. Gavin came up to me and says, oh, you're friends with somebody I work with, Steve Albini. Oh, really? You know, we're good friends. And he's a good friend. He's like, so we're all friends. Pretty cool.
You're iconic for your fine neck guitar. Everyone talks about your fine neck guitar and stuff like that.
I don't have
Oh, come on, man. You didn't bring it? Too heavy?
We couldn't bring it.
But tell me about how that came to life. Whose idea was? Was your idea? How did it start?
Years ago, it's like I used to stack one on top of another. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'd have five, and I played a little bit, get rid of it, play the next one, throw it away. Before you know it, I was carrying 4 or 5 guitars. So I decided to make one guitar, but it was going to be 6 necks that spun. But then Billy Gibbons came up with a guitar that spun around, so I said, well, they're going to think I copied him, and I didn't want to. So I had asked Hamer to make me a guitar. They made me a 5 neck. That was the first. I wish I had it here, but no, I didn't bring it.
What would you be advice for young musicians who want to start getting into the guitar? What would you suggest to be the first guitar to start practicing with?
Just get one that feels good. You know, I have guitars that you got to get it. Doesn't matter if it's expensive or cheap, or you know what. Whatever fits in your hand right, so start there, then work on the others. I mean, I've got guitars that are very hard to play, but they smell good.
You guys released an album, if I'm not mistaken, in 2021, the latest one. It was right when the pandemic was starting, so I wonder, how was to release an album during these hard times, and how was the reception? So were you guys have any concerns about releasing at that time?
No, you know, we can't control what happens outside of, we can't even control what we do, let alone control what what others think or whatever. So it just came out at a good time. You have to look at it. You have to look at the positive. And the positive is, hey.
I remember seeing you guys last time. I think it was with Def Leppard in Newcastle. What were your most fond memories of that tour?
Just being in Australia. I love it. I've been coming here since the 70s. So it's wonderful. Wonderful people, beautiful, not raining.
You rather to play big arenas or small?
I like the big, small. Like this room. This could be a good rock room too. Just, you know, guitar, bass, and drums real loud and cool in here. I don't know. I like all sides.
You know, when this place opened, Hard Rock Cafe Sydney, your friend, and I think you're still friends with Angry Anderson, performing that small stage here. So I wonder, you still get along with Angry? You contact each other?
I like him. He's a good hard rock and roller. Known for a long time. I hope he still remembers me.
You mentioned you actually got to meet and hang out with, back in the day, with Angus and Malcolm Young. Unfortunately, Malcolm not being with us. It's been a big, big blow for the Australian audience. So I wonder, what are your most fond memories of Malcolm?
Well, did you see the picture that was out here?
Yeah.
That was with me playing with him? Yeah. Well, we were just good, you know. We toured together, so it was great. It was great I had the opportunity to do that tour with AC/DC. And we were, at the time, we were unknown and they were unknown. And we got along good. It was just great playing, great band. Great that we got to know them.
For you, as such an iconic musician in the industry, how
important?
Yeah, you are, mate. Come on, you're very humble, but you are. I think everyone here look up to you, and pretty much every fan that is there, all the other bands, everyone looks up to you, mate. And I appreciate that you're very humble with this.
I'm a songwriter.
Speaking about that, what comes first, a songwriter, the lyrics or the music?
Me.
You go, sir.
Yeah, I don't know. Depends. Every song is different. Some the lyrics, some the music, some the idea, some the beat, some who knows?